Good Thursday evening. I'm meteorologist Elizabeth Hart. Mother Nature throws us a treat for Halloween. Another gorgeous day coming tomorrow. Mostly sunny skies. Temperatures a bit warmer. Highs in the mid to upper 80s. We'll have full details on your weekend forecast coming up next on WB 38 News at 10. Welcome back to WB 38 News at 10. We did get off to a rather chilly start, but we made a brilliant recovery during the afternoon. We bottomed out at a cool 60 degrees at the airport. Normal low there is 64. 85 the afternoon high. 82 is normal on that front. Nothing in the way of precip. And in fact, looks like we may stay rain-free until the very end of the weekend. Mostly clear skies right now at Tampa International. 73 degrees there. Humidity nice and comfortable at 64%. Winds coming in out of the east between 5 and 10 miles per hour. Pressure on the high side, and it is actually still rising. Now, if you like today, chances are you're going to be pretty happy about tomorrow. Mostly sunny skies will rule. We'll have that nice, dry, north-northeasterly breeze, so the humidity is going to be very, very comfortable. Temperatures may actually be a couple degrees warmer than they were this afternoon. Looking for about 85 northward in Inverness, 87 in Tampa, 87 in St. Pete, and we may be as warm as 88 southward into Sarasota. Satellite and radar relatively uninteresting this evening. We did have a few high, thin clouds float in late this afternoon, but even those have really dissipated here during the evening time period. This is the reason we're going to see such gorgeous conditions. High pressure is going to dominate all the way from the Gulf Coast right on up into the Ohio Valley. So maybe if you're trekking off to the west along I-10 through the early part of the weekend over towards New Orleans or heading north on 95 up towards the North Carolina Piedmont, everybody should be seeing some unseasonably warm and sunny conditions for at least the next couple of days. But because of the position of this area of high pressure, we get a clockwise flow coming in around that, it may actually have some negative consequences in the latter half of the weekend. We're looking at an area of disturbed weather out in the central Atlantic. It does look like, because of the high over the southeast, it will help steer this low in the general vicinity of southern Florida. Now, it's not exactly real definitive at this point as to what's going to transpire, but this certainly could undergo some strengthening in the next 48 hours and potentially become a tropical depression, a tropical storm, something of that nature. But the good news is, even if it does continue on this path, it should be well south of the Bay Area, and it's going to be a fast mover. So yes, it may bring some heavier rain to places like Miami, maybe even as far northward as Naples, but we will certainly be on the northern fringe of all that. And if we do see anything at all from that particular system, it should be relatively short-lived. As we take a look at the rest of the state tonight, there just isn't a whole lot going on. Nice clear skies in the panhandle heading all the way down towards Orlando into Lake Okeechobee. We did have a couple of showers breaking out around the Bahamas late this afternoon, and because of that strong easterly flow, they made their way all the way over towards Miami. Nothing in the way of rainfall around here tomorrow, that's for sure. Your Halloween looks great, mostly sunny skies, highs in the upper 80s, a repeat performance on Saturday. Again, a few more clouds because of that low Sunday afternoon, about a 40% chance of some showers and thunderstorms, and a little cooler as we start the work week. David?
Thanks, Elizabeth. Oh, who?